Alright, welcome back to another tutorial in Maya. Today, I think what we'll take a look at is adding some sound effects, sort of some timing to some sounds. And as you can see here, I just sort of have a very simple collision setup, no big deal. But what we want to do is we want to add some sound effects in here or use sound, because sometimes it might influence the timing of what you're doing, and you might need to bring a sound effect in here and actually work with it. It happens a lot with dialogue and stuff like that, but for the most part you probably won't be using, you know, audio elements necessarily in Maya, because Maya sort of has a very anemic audio capabilities. It's just very basic. So let's take a look at the real quick basics of adding some sound here. Let's look at our animation and just sort of know that we're gonna add some crashes and some glass and stuff like that. Just some sort of sound effects to accent what's happening here, because you may need to be timing something or animating something to the timing of a sound effect. So anyway, before we do that, let's go over there and take a look at Lester Banks, because Lester is always out there. He finds good stuff every day, and I mean it, every day. And it's a great resource on the internet. So if you're not familiar with Lester Banks, go over and check him out, lesterbanks.com. Maya tutorials, After Effects, Cinema 4D, you name it. A lot of good stuff over there. So thank you, Lester, for being good to my brain. All right. So let's get on with it. Let's take a look at what Maya likes. AIFF and WAV files. So you'll want to convert, you know, make sure that your file formats for your sounds are either in AIFF or WAV. And if you're on a Mac, you can use an MP3 and drag and drop it directly into the timeline. But if you're not on a Mac, you cannot drag and drop MP3s into the timeline, I guess. I'm on a Mac, so it's cool. You just drag and drop it into the timeline. So anyway, here's what we're gonna do. Let's go back to the beginning here. Let's look at our animation and see what's happening. All right, so I have three sound effects prepared that I'm gonna take a look at here. And let's just sort of zoom in here. And it's as easy as dragging and dropping a sound file on top of any of your windows here. If I were in the four port, you could drag and drop into any of these windows and the sound effect will show up in your timeline. So I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna drag and drop one into my main timeline here. And I think what we'll do is I'll go with this, I'm dragging this file in. It's called Auto Crash Metal 1, AIF. And I'm gonna drag it in there. Well, you can see it shows up in the timeline down here depending on what you have set in your timeline. And so that right there is the sound effect. Now, by default, sometimes it's set to not playing sound. So you may wanna come up to your sound, and then, you know, you're going to be using maybe track sound, or, you know, right now this is the only one that got added in there. So, you know, I know that Auto Crash Metal 1 is in there. So anyway, let's go to sound and go up here into playback speed. And right now I'm on play every frame max real time. So I'm just going to check out and see if it added that sound effect. Okay. And I can't hear anything playing from the beginning. I'm going to go back and forth to the beginning, and I can't hear it play. I can see the sound wave right there. So that's cool. What I need to do is right mouse click with your cursor in the timeline down here and come back up here to playback speed, and always just go with real time. That will give you, that will make the audio play at real time. So I'll go ahead and set it to real time there. Okay, and I hope you can hear this. This is coming through my speakers, but here, there's the sound effect. I'm gonna switch back over here into my main viewport, go back here to the beginning, and we'll take a play from the beginning here. Well, you can see where when you drag and drop, you know, an audio clip into your interface over here, it adds it down here, but it adds it at frame one. And we really don't want it to be at frame one. We want it to be more like, let's see, let's go back to the animation beginning and about right a little bit before there. So let's say we want it to come in at like 35 or something like that. Well, the easiest way to do this is to make sure you have your outliner open, And come over here, make sure your display has, you know, the DAGs is unchecked up here. You don't want a check mark in there. And then you'll be able to see all of the stuff that's going on in here. And in this case, I dragged and dropped a AIFF file, and it should show up over here. There it is, as an audio signal, or what Maya designates as an audio signal. So I'm going to check on that. When you activate it in the Outliner, you'll notice it comes up into your attribute editor, and it has an offset of 0, meaning right now it's at frame 0, which is up here. So I'm going to switch that offset to something, say, like 35. Okay, I'll put 35 in there, and then you'll notice it changes its position down here. Sometimes you need to click into the timeline down here to have them switch around so they look correct. So now we'll play it. Okay. And there it is. Pretty simple. Okay, let's get a little more complex. Let's take a look at this sort of as it's playing out now. And let's just do a quick play. Okay, I'll live with that for the moment. Now I see that this one is sort of, you know, crashing down at a certain point. So I may want to take note of when this hits here, which is like roughly frame 80. All right, so let's add a sound effect in for this crash at like 80. I have another one over here called, let's see, Crash Glass. That might sound pretty good. I'm gonna drag and drop it into my main viewport here, and there it is. So I'm gonna go back to the beginning and play. All right, so this sound effect is now set at 0 by default, so we need to offset it and put it at, you know, wherever we think it should go, which in this case, it should go about there, at about frame 80 or something like that. So once again, come over into the Outliner. I'll go down here and find that. Now right now that Auto Crash Metal 1 is there, but my new one that I just brought in is down here, the Crash Glass. So I'll go ahead and check that, and I'll set the offset to say 85. All right. I'll go back to the beginning. Okay, let's take a look at that and see how bad it is. Here we go. Yeah, all right, so you get the idea. You're going to see them stack up in the timeline as you bring more and more in. And, you know, you can just sort of use that as a guideline to animate. Like I said, most of the time you're going to be using that to do blend shapes with dialogue and animating, you know, lip sync kind of stuff. But really the audio editing capabilities inside of Maya are, they're limited at best. Okay, so I could adjust this timing a little bit more to come in sort of at... Let's see here. Let's find out. About 90. Let's switch this up to say 90. And we'll go back to the beginning. Nope. 90 is not it. So let's go back and maybe switch that to like 80. All right. Okay, so you get the idea. Time out your stuff. Okay, so that's about all I got for you on this one. Let's see. One other thing. If you want to see what's happening with your audio clips down here, you can always go up here into your window and come into your animation editors and grab your tracks editor. Click on that, and it'll bring up a window. It says tracks editor here. And if you're not seeing soundtrack, you may need to click on one of these guys over here. All right, that'll kind of toggle you back and forth. And if I roll down my soundtrack, you can see where the two audio waveforms are there. Not much to look at here. Nothing really that you can do with this audio in here other than, say, mute it. So I could mute that, or I could mute that one, or I could mute them both. And that's about it. Sometimes you need to set your playback range. This will give you the full range. This will center around the current frame or current time. So really that's about all you have to work with there. So no big deal. The key is sometimes you just need a sound effect to work with to kind of get an idea of how it's going to look or whatever. So that's how you do it. All right. And don't forget to right click down here into the timeline. And you also have some various other options. You know, you can pick either some sounds to work with the waveform. Like if I was matching a beat to a waveform, I might want to say, well, let's set the primary beat right there, and you know, whatever. You can see what your waveform is doing. And then remember, on your playback speed, it has to be on real time, but sometimes, you know, simulations only play back correctly when you play every frame. So it can be a little tricky, at least with the 2011 version here, working with audio if you need to. So there you go. Remember, you have some other options down here. I usually leave looping at continuous, whatever. And then setting range too. This is sort of interesting because, you know, I have a simulation going on here, but I could set my range to, you know, a sound length. And I might as well just do that for the moment. Let me come over here and I'm going to drag and drop a different audio clip over into my interface here. It's called Glacial AIF. All right. And it kind of, you can see where it's going on there. It placed it at frame one, and it goes all the way up to the end of frame 300. So if I start playing, okay, there's my audio sample. But really, this audio sample is a lot longer than 300 frames. So if I were to right mouse click over here in the timeline and come back up into sound, let's see here, we want to go down to set range 2 and come down to sound length. I'll go ahead and do that. And it says no sound displayed, import a sound file. Okay. Well, we need to actually choose this. We need to choose this file. So I'm going to go right mouse click and go back to sound, set range 2. And we're going to pick this sound. Let's go to sound and come into our glacial, and now we have that sort of highlighted in the timeline. I'm going to go ahead and right mouse click again and set range 2 and then the actual sound length of this clip, and then you can see where it actually extends your clip to 1536, whatever. So now I could play this whole simulation back. And it's going to, you know, play that sound form, waveform, or play that audio clip. So it seems a little wonky right here. We should be hearing it. Oh, okay. Now, here's another thing to be aware of. If it's not playing back everything as you expect, you may want to come back over here into your sound and then go back into use track sounds, because right now I have glacial selected. The other ones are playing, but sometimes it's a little wonky. You may want to have to go back to use track sounds. Now if I go back to the beginning, it seems to be playing it, you know, correctly. So anyway, I don't know if you can hear that, but there you go. All right, well, that's about it for this tutorial. Not much to it. I wish audio was a lot easier to use in Maya, but it's not. just due to, you know, rendering issues and playback issues and whatnot. So, okay, so that's all I got for you. Remember, be a good person and, you know, read the owner's manual. Read the help section. Sometimes you need to come over into here and, you know, click help. And if you just maybe click in, like, say, audio, put audio in for that. Audio. And let's see what happens. My help. You know, you can basically type it in there and you can get some information on audio. All right. So anyway, have a good one, and thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.